Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to calculate composite functions and their domains. To complete this problem, we'll calculate four composites from two functions and then specify the domain of each. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been given two functions, f of x equals x plus 1 over x, and g of x equals x plus 1 over x plus 2, and we've been asked to find the compositions f of g of f of f, and g of g, and once we find the compositions, we've been asked to state their domains, the domains of the compositions. So this will be in two parts. One, we'll be finding the compositions of these functions, and then we'll be stating the domains of the compositions. So let's take a look at f of g first. We can denote f of g as f of g like this, that composition notation. That's equal to f of g of x. And both of these kinds of notations mean the same thing. We're just going to be plugging g of x here into our f of x function. So we have to look at g of x as x plus 1 over x plus 2, and we're going to be plugging that in to f of x everywhere where we see x in our f of x function. So what that looks like here, we'll take g of x and we'll plug it in to f of x here and here. So that looks like this, x plus 1 over x plus 2 for that first x, then continuing on with our f of x function, plus 1 divided by, and now we're plugging in g of x again, x plus 1 over x plus 2. So you're just taking g of x and plugging it in to f of x. So at this point, we've really found the composition. All we have left to do is simplify this function and find the domain. So in order to simplify this second term here, 1 divided by x plus 1 over x plus 2, we can just flip that fraction here in the denominator and take the reciprocal. So we'll have x plus 1 over x plus 2. This second fraction is just going to flip, and it's going to be x plus 2 over x plus 1. Whenever you have 1 divided by a fraction like that, you just flip the fraction and the 1 goes away. And now we can find a common denominator by multiplying the first term by x plus 1 and the second x plus 1 over x plus 1 and the second term by x plus 2 over x plus 2. And what we'll end up with is basically x plus 1 times x plus 1 plus x plus 2 times x plus 2 with a common denominator here of x plus 1 times x plus 2. So when we simplify our numerator, we'll get x squared plus 2x plus 1 plus x squared plus 4x plus 4 all over our denominator, x plus 1 times x plus 2. And when we simplify, you can see that we'll get 2x squared plus 6x plus 5 all over x plus 1 times x plus 2. At this point, because we can't simplify any further or factor anything out, we know that our domain will be all real numbers except those that cause the denominator to be equal to 0. So we know that the denominator will be equal to 0 when x is equal to negative 1 and when x is equal to negative 2. So we can say that the domain here, the domain is x not equal to negative 1 or negative 2. The important thing to remember about domains of compositions is that the domain is defined by the composition itself, but also by the inside function here, g of x. So whatever we put inside, the domain has to consider that as well. So if we look at the domain of g of x itself, we can see that the domain of g of x is x not equal to negative 2. We already indicated that x cannot be equal to negative 2 in the domain that we found for the composition f of g of x. So in this case, we don't have to include any other qualifiers on the domain. But if our answer here had been different for the domain of g of x, we would have had to include that as well. So let's look at another example here, g of f, which we know to be the same thing as g of f of x. And in this case, we'll just be plugging in f of x to our function g of x. So we're going to take x plus 1 over x and plug it in to g of x everywhere we see x, so here and here. And what we'll get is x plus 1 over x plus 1, because we're in the denominator of our g of x function, divided by x plus 1 over x plus 2. Now we just need to simplify our composition and find the domain. So simplifying the composition, we'll multiply everything by x over x to find a common denominator in both the numerator and the denominator. So we'll get x squared over x plus 1 over x plus x over x, again multiplying each term by x over x. And then in the denominator here, same kind of thing, we'll get x squared over x plus 1 over x plus 2x over x. Then when we find the common denominator, we'll get x squared plus 1 plus x, all divided by x, over x squared plus 2x plus 1, just reordering terms a little bit, all over x. Our x terms here in the denominator will cancel, these will cancel, and we'll just be left with x squared plus x plus 1, again reordering terms from that numerator there, all divided by x squared plus 2x plus 1, which we can factor into x plus 1 times x plus 1, or the quantity x plus 1 squared. So this is our composition, and we can see, since it's a rational function, or the quotient of two polynomials, that the domain is just going to be all real numbers except where the denominator is equal to 0. So we can see that the denominator will be equal to 0 whenever x is equal to negative 1, so we know that x cannot be equal to negative 1. But as we learned in the last example, we can't just stop there. We have to also include the domain of f of x. We know that f of x has to be considered here because it's the inside function. So the domain over here of f of x is all x not equal to 0. We can't have x equal to 0 because we have this x in the denominator here. So we have to modify the domain of the composition g of f and say that x cannot be equal to negative 1, but it can also not be equal to 0. Our last two compositions, f of f and g of g, we can look at in the same way. So we know that f of f is equal to f of x, and it's the same concept. We're just going to be plugging x plus 1 over x into our same function, f of x, wherever we see x. So we'll take x plus 1 over x, that'll come in for x, then we'll say plus 1 divided by, and plug it in again for this x here, so we'll say x plus 1 over x, and now we just need to simplify. Again, we'll need to find a common denominator, and the way that we'll do that is by finding a common denominator here in the denominator of our third term. So we'll multiply this first term by x over x to get x squared plus 1 all over x. Because it's 1 divided by that fraction, it's just going to flip that fraction upside down. We'll get x plus 1 over x plus x over x squared plus 1. And now you can see we need to find a common denominator between all three of these terms. So we'll see that we can find a common denominator of x times x squared plus 1. So we'll multiply our first term here times x squared plus 1 over x times x squared plus 1. Our second term here by x squared plus 1 over x squared plus 1. And our third term by x over x. And now when we simplify, you'll see that we get x to the fourth plus x squared plus x squared plus 1 plus x squared, all divided by x times x squared plus 1. When we simplify the numerator, we'll get x to the fourth plus 3x squared plus 1, all divided by x times x squared plus 1. This is our composite. We just need to identify the points where our denominator is equal to 0, and we just need to exclude those points from our domain. So this term here, x squared plus 1, can never be equal to 0, because no matter what we plug in for x, we'll get a positive number. When we add 1 to that, we'll still have a positive number, no problem. But this variable here, x, will give us a 0 when we plug in 0, so we know that for our domain, x cannot equal 0. We also have to check f of x because it's the inside function and look at its domain. We already know that the domain for f of x says that x cannot be equal to 0. We've already indicated that in our domain for f of f, the composite, so we know that the domain for the entire composite is x not equal to 0. For the last composite, g of g, we know that g of g is equal to g of x, and we'll take g of x and plug that into g of x everywhere we see x. So we know that we're plugging in x plus 1 over x plus 2 everywhere where we see x. So we'll say x plus 1 over x plus 2 plus 1 for the numerator, all over x plus 1 over x plus 2 plus 2 for the denominator. Now we just need to simplify our composite and then define the domain. So we'll find a common denominator in both the numerator and the denominator of our fraction, and we'll get x plus 1. We'll multiply this 1 here by x plus 2 over x plus 2 to find a common denominator. So we'll get plus x plus 2 all over x plus 2. In the denominator, same thing, we'll multiply this 2 by x plus 2 over x plus 2, and we'll get x plus 1 plus 2x plus 4, all divided by x plus 2. Our x plus 2s will cancel from our denominators, and we'll just be left with the numerator here, which will simplify to 2x plus 3, all divided by our simplified denominator here, which is 3x plus 5, and we have our simplified composite function. Now, for the domain, we just have to figure out where this composite is undefined and where g of x is undefined, since it's the inside function. Here, since we have a rational function, the quotient of two polynomials, our function is only undefined where the denominator is equal to 0, so we need to figure out where 3x plus 5 is equal to 0. We'll get 3x equal to negative 5, or x equals negative 5/3. So we know that x cannot equal negative 5/3, but we also have to consider g of x itself. We know that the domain of g of x is x not equal to negative 2, so we can say that the domain of the composite g of g, or g of x, is equal to x not equal to negative 5/3, or negative 2. And that's it. That's how you find the composition of functions and their domains. So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.